Stop resisting. Stop resisting.
Stop.
You need to
stop resisting.
30 seconds after he's handcuffed, officers appear to realize Ambler is unresponsive. They perform CPR. Medical units arrive on the scene. Ambler was pronounced dead less than an hour later. Bree, I can only imagine how difficult it is for you to hear this. What was your reaction when you first saw it?
I tried to avoid it at all costs, but once it went viral and went national, it was no avoiding it. It ripped my heart out. And that's why I wanted to speak and have my son speak, to know, to let the world know exactly how much pain this type of thing brings onto a family.
Deavion, if you're able to talk, what do you want the world to know about your dad?
This whole situation, you know, it takes a toll on people. You know, this situation changed my life. You know, like, this made me look at the world way different. Like, it takes a huge toll on people, and that the absence of my father now is. I just really want justice for my pops, but for my dad.
Bree, as the mother of two boys, how does that make you feel right now? When you think about what happened to their father,
and
you're now raising two boys, two African American boys in this world.
It makes me feel empty. They were not a statistic before. You know, the stereotype is that black men aren't around. And the state of Texas has allowed Williamson County to go on like this for so long, and they have made my children statistics now. And that's an empty feeling. He was a good dad. All he did revolved around those kids. And, you know, I tip my hat to his father and his mother, because they raised an exceptional man. And it's very rare that you see this in the black community, where parents split up and there's great, great energy and it's a great relationship. We've never had any drama. 20 plus years, we've never had the drama. He's always been there for us. He's always been there for these boys. And we've always been great, close friends, family. You know, we've lost the loved one. He was the glue. You could always call on him. And to see the change in my sons and them kind of spiral downward, they've never had issues in school with grades or anything. My son's a senior this year. He had difficulties focusing. He had difficulties with school due to this, you know, and it's a traumatic experience.
Davion, what has this done so far in terms of your view of how this world is for you? And I guess I'm asking you about how you see police, but also just how you feel about yourself.
It's not only how I see police, and it's not how I see the world. It's about how I see the things that went on. Like, I can't even see a white Honda Pilot without having, you know, a breakdown the same way. I can't see a white officer in a uniform the same way. I can't see anything that was caused in my father's situation the same way. It makes me look at everything different. Everything that was involved different. It takes a mental turn on anybody. I don't wish this on nobody to lose their parent. You know, it basically takes me. I'm a loss of words. I'm a loss of words.
Bre, the Austin District Attorney's investigating, but obviously the Office of Professional Standards at the County Sheriff Department had concluded deputies acted in accordance with department policies. But as I said, District Attorney investigating and says she will present this case to a grand jury this summer. What do you want to happen here?
Justice. We want justice. It's not a pacify us with a settlement or anything like that. We want justice. You know, they took his last breath. He was in distress, clearly. His face, his voice, he was losing his breath. And anybody that was on that scene physically, if they couldn't hear it and see it, and we saw it and heard it on a video, why are they on the force? You know, for him to arrogantly say how he broke his finger, that man said that in a way that he did not care. He did not care about the life. He didn't care about the limbs or anything. And at that moment, it looked as though Javier's body was limp and he was already probably unconscious or deceased when he arrogantly said how he broke his finger. So the DA needs to go for the highest of charges, not a slap on the wrist. We're tired of seeing a slap on the wrist. That's all these officers get. Manslaughter with 2 years in prison, and they go out, even if they even go to prison. This is why it's continuing to happen, because we're not getting any justice. We're not getting anybody who's getting made an example. You know, it was a black officer that accidentally shot a Caucasian lady, and he got sentenced to 12 years. But this young lady in Dallas goes into a gentleman's apartment, and she has 10 years, but she's probably only going to serve a year or two. You know, so that type of difference, treat them all the same when they take a life, and especially when someone is begging for their life. His last words were, "Please save me." So may God have mercy.
It's not doing nothing but building up hatred.
Well, you don't need to do that.
I'm 18 years old. My dad can't even see me graduate. It was hard to graduate. It took a mental turn. It was hard to graduate. It took a mental turn on me in school.
This is what they did.
Now he can't see me in my cap and gown. Now he can't see me. I can't, you know.
This is the type of pain that they cause when they do this. When they do unjustifiable murders, this is the pain they cause. My 15-year-old son can't barely talk on the phone sometimes. He couldn't sleep. He couldn't even sleep in the room anymore because he was seeing his father. You know, this is the mental trauma that you are causing on our black children. Do you all understand that? I need them to hear that. Stop portraying these guys as suspects. Stop portraying them as horrible people. Same with the George Floyd situation in Aubrey. They always want to make them a suspect. They always want to make them look like the bad guy. Hey, every black guy, every black man, every black woman, we're not all bad. Every race has a bad apple. But you cannot go about this like this anymore. We need justice. We need equality, and we need solidarity. What's hard about that?
Bre, I thank you. And Davion, thank you so much.
Thank you.
I'm so, so sorry to both of you, and of course, to your brother, your son, for your incalculable loss.
I'm always going to ride for you, Javier. We love you, and we're going to keep it going. This isn't going to stop. This isn't the last stop. We're going to keep his name alive. We're going to keep his memory alive, and we're going to stay in their face to show them this, what they leave us behind with, what they leave young black men behind. This is, you know, he's entering life. They're going to enter life. They have no father to call when they need advice. You know, think about that. Your children can still pick up the phone and speak with you. Your children do not mean more than my children.